The worst of the storm has now reached New Orleans.
At least one levee has broken.
Under 10 to 12 feet of
buildings
water.
Have collapsed.
It's just heartbreaking.
After Hurricane Katrina, Steve Gleason helped the city of New Orleans rise again.
Last year, so much hopelessness inside this arena, it's been replaced by the sounds of hope and rebirth.
You feel like a shotgun blast goes off, and that's the sound of the ball hitting Steve Gleason's hand.
This is one of those moments that was so much bigger than just football.
And after 8 seasons in the NFL, Steve retired and married New Orleans native Michelle Verisco. Life was good. They traveled the world and planned to start a family. But a few years later, Steve experienced a hurricane of his own.
I have been diagnosed with amyotrophic lateral sclerosis.
But Steve's a fighter. Instead of deciding to die, he decided to live. ALS is a neurodegenerative disease that separates the brain from the rest of the body. And while it slowed him down, Steve Gleason has proven to be virtually unstoppable. Steve and Michelle not only decided to have a child, they decided to live and ultimately made a film about it.
This is intended to be a gift for you.
Not knowing if he'd be able to speak to his unborn son, Steve began making a video diary for him. This would become the critically acclaimed documentary, Gleason, raising awareness of what it's like to live with ALS while inspiring millions around the world. And when it came to staying ahead of ALS, Steve not only helped develop technology that would improve his life, he started a revolutionary foundation to provide it for others. Team Gleason was founded with a mission to help people living with ALS realize their purpose by sponsoring extraordinary life adventures, as well as provide them with the technology they need to continue to thrive. Over the last 7 years, Team Gleason has sent people living with ALS on trips to Italy, Montana, Hawaii, Africa, 2 Super Bowls, Peru, and many, many others. The foundation has not only provided leading-edge assistant technology and equipment to thousands of people living with ALS, but also opened the Team Gleason House for innovative living, where up to 18 people living with ALS can live as productively and as independently as possible. Team Gleason also held an international summit in New Orleans, and for the first time, people living with ALS shared the stage with leading researchers, developing a business plan to find a treatment or cure for the disease in their lifetime. Steve's taken his battle to world leaders to pass legislation.
The Steve Gleason Act is now the law of the land.
In order to provide technology to those living with neurodegenerative diseases across the country, he's met with heads of industry and medicine, challenging them to improve technology and the science that will someday lead to an answer for ALS. Because Steve believes sports can oftentimes reflect life, and winning isn't everything. He created a set of sports and life skills clinics for kids, all while staying continually active as a father, one of his most important roles.
Did you make any new friends today?
No.
Did you play with Cohen today, bro?
No, he had fever.
Ultimately, Steve's response to being diagnosed with ALS is to end ALS, and not for him, but for you and I, while improving the lives of those who continue to fight it around the world. And he's just getting started.